Hi and welcome to another Logic Pro Song Sketch episode. In today's episode, let's make use of the new sound packs bundled with Logic Pro 10.8, namely the Vox Melodics and the Hybrid Textures package to create a little song sketch. Let's take the tour. Right, so before we start any music production today, we need to make sure that we have the latest sound packs installed with Logic Pro 10.8. So let's go to the Logic Pro menu, go to Sound Library and open Sound Library Manager. Within the Sound Library Manager, just go into the Sound Packs folder and make sure that you have the Hybrid Textures and the Vox Melodics vocal loops installed. If not, just check them and press the Install button. Next up, we need to find these excellent vocal loops. To do that, we can open the loop browser, either by pressing O on the keyboard or this icon up here. And by default, Logic Pro shows us all sound packs. But for this particular project, we want to make sure that we only use sounds from the new sound packs. So we can press this Show All button and just select at the bottom here, the Vox Melodics.
You're running circles around me every time. You're my automatic. Gotta keep it in drive.
Look at me. Look at me.
Oh no. Look at me. No.
Back and forth. I like it back.
I'm bending back for you. I'm bending back for you.
So there are some really sweet loops, as you can hear in this package, but I think we're gonna use some of these Ruby loops.
Just wanna say you're all mine.
Okay, so let's use this Ruby automatic verse 1. And if we look to the right of this, we can see it's 16 bars, the BPM is 85, and the key is C sharp minor. Another thing that I do before I start any project is go to this menu bar and select custom, so we get a better overview of at the toolbar. So if we say that we have the project at 120 BPM and we drag this verse, which is 85 BPM, and let's drag it just to an empty track here in the arrangement. We actually get to select if we want to import the tempo from this loop. So let's do that.
You're my automatic. Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic. Just wanna say you're all mine.
Right, so a quick break before we continue. If you want to learn the full potential of Logic Pro, I have the perfect course for you in my Logic Pro for Beginners course. You can check it out at store.morningdewmedia.com. See you in the course. Let's continue. I think that the next natural step is to find a bass sound and create a bass line, so we can later add some chords. So let's add a new software instrument track and get rid of the electric piano. And let's see, I think we can go to the all sounds in the library and find the synth bass. So let's go into synthesizer, bass, and the 90s solid synth bass. Time for some headphones. Let's also activate the metronome by pressing K. Now I'm gonna open Synthesia, another application here, just so that you can see what kind of notes I play on the bass here.
Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic. Just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic.
Yes, let's add something like that. And record some bass.
You're my automatic. Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic. Just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic.
Now let's select this clip and press Q to quantize.
You're my automatic. Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic. Just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic. Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic. Just wanna say you're all mine.
Right, so let's add some drums. We can right click and add a new drummer track. And we know it's 85 BPM, so it's going to be some kind of hip-hop or lo-fi or, yeah, R&B kind of thing. But let's go for modern hip-hop and see what we get. Let's just align the clip with the other clips.
You're my automatic. gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic, gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine.
A really cool feature with the drummers in Melodic Pro is that you can make them follow along to a certain melodic part or a bass part or something. If you go to the kick snare claps at the bottom of the drummer section here and you activate follow, you get to select another track. So let's track the 90s solid synth bass. So now you can see that the drum track changed a little bit and it's gonna play more along the lines of what I played on the bass.
Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic, gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic, gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic.
Right, so let's add a little bit of punch to the drums here. So we activate the fat effects and we open the fat effects and add a little bit of saturation in the distortion part.
You're my automatic, gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic, gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic, gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine. You're my automatic.
So you can hear that the fat effects really fattens up the drums and make them pop and bring them more into the front in the mix.
Gotta keep it in drive. And I know it's tragic, just wanna say you're all mine.
Right, so we added some vocals, we added some drums, we have some bass, and now it's time to add some chords. So let's see if we can find something in the new hybrid textures package. So if we go and add a new software instrument track, and again remove it this electric piano, select no plugin, and we go up to library and select the hybrid textures. We get to select the only patches from this specific library. So let's go into synthesizers and see if we can find something fun in the classics maybe. That's a clicky, fun little sound. Let's see how that suits with the piece. Yeah, that might really suit this piece, actually. Maybe we need to adjust the delay a little bit, but let's hear how it sounds with the vocals, actually. And again, select the part and press Q to quantize. Okay, so before we start adding some complementary melodic instrument, I think we need to double this. So select everything and press Command R to make it double the length. And let's see if we can find let's drag in some fillers. Make them sound in the middle, in between these other vocal phrases. And let's move this other part to some other part of the track. And we need to add a lot of reverb to this. and place them more in the background with less volume. Oops, wrong track. And let's move this to the second part, second verse repetitions. We have a few different types of ad-libs in the different in between silence sections between the melodies. And let's have the same phrase for the end there. Next up, let's add some complementary melody, played arpeggio with almost like a kalimba. Something like that for the second verse, so we get a little bit of variation for the first and second part. As you can see, I didn't record this time, but there's a really sweet feature in Logic Pro that is that it's always listening to what you enter into the MIDI. So we can press Shift and R, and bam, magically we have the MIDI that I played in our track. And let's finally add a little cymbal in the beginning here, or some kind of noise effect. Yeah, let's use this kind of dark cymbal. Let's make a duplicate of the cymbal, press Command R, and drag that to this part of the verse. Make another duplicate and make it a few bars, like so. And we will set reverse in the region inspector. And that way we reverse this clip and we can make a small fade in like this. Even make it shorter and move it so we have a little sweep into this third beat. So we have some ear candy happening. Okay, so I think I like the drums here, but I need to add a kick at the very beginning and also the second time here. So we can just transform this into MIDI clips. So right click and convert to MIDI region. Now we can just go in there and add a little kick. Let's convert this into a pattern region. Just for the sake of it, because you can see we can have pattern regions and MIDI regions on the same track. Let's add a kick there. Right, so that's how you can simply create a small song sketch using some of the new sounds in Logic Pro 10.8. Now the next step would be maybe to replace this vocal with your own lyrics and vocal melody. But it's actually a really great starting point to have some kind of vocal phrases in the background to help you get inspired and get going with the melodic material in your tracks. Please let me know in the comments what you think about this little sketch, and I hope to see you in my Logic Pro course for beginners. Thanks for watching today, and I'll see you in the next episode. My name is Mattias. Bye.